Alright, what's up guys? So recently I graduated school and moved to a new location, so that's why you see this new background behind me. So I wanted to also thank you guys for the support on my last video. It's pretty crazy. There was so much support, so many more subscribers now, so much more people to the Polish American Rodzina here on YouTube. So it's pretty cool. I was actually shocked that there was that many views, like in subscribers from that video, and also just the support from it too. It was nice to hear. Alright guys, so on my channel a while back, I came out with a series called Poland versus USA, Poland versus America. Basically, I go over the differences between the two countries and some of the small things. So I've done topics about fashion, homes, and also stereotypes too. And today I plan to make a differences video from Poland versus USA on holidays. So to start off, there's a holiday in Poland called Name Day. Basically, I can't give you a date on this because it ranges from your name. So simply like, so for example, my girlfriend's name is Adriana and her name day is on September 8th. So my name is Trevor, so I probably don't have a name day because my name is not Polish in any regards. So I guess if I was gonna go by my alternative, my Polish name, Tadeusz, then I guess I would have a name day then. As far as I know, name day, you're basically just like, I guess, celebrating your name, and it's kind of a strange one. We definitely don't do it here in the States. I guess you kind of, it's like a smaller type of celebration, but it's definitely a thing. You know, I guess flowers, maybe like a small cake or something. But yeah, it's quite interesting to me. We don't have that in the States. So I'm gonna try to go in order with some of the most popular holidays in Poland, and I'm gonna kind of compare from my perspective as an American how they differ from ours. Alright guys, so I wanted to add a disclaimer, which is I've only been in Poland for around 90 days total, and my girlfriend gave me this list of some of the most important holidays in Poland. Now obviously with both countries there's basically holidays every single day. You know, there's cake day, there's shoe day, there's, you know, every single day has a holiday for probably both countries now. So I kind of wanted to highlight the most important ones to myself and my girlfriend. So those are the ones that I'm going to be talking about in this list. So obviously we share January 1st and New Year's as the same day. Oh, so I also wanted to note about January 1st. In Poland, there's actually fireworks pretty much all day long in most cities. I'm sure this is going to be reformed within a few years, because it almost seems, I was scared. So quick story time. So I was actually in Gdańsk on January 1st 2 years ago, and I woke up to the sound of fireworks, and whenever I went out to the streets to go get food, there was just fireworks and chaos all in the streets for 24 hours. Everyone was just launching fireworks just right in the street, and this amazed me. I was so surprised, and I had anxiety like the entire day, because if you just hear fireworks, the sound of fireworks during the day, it's probably not fireworks in the US, it's probably guns. And this is something I was actually pretty afraid about in Poland, and I'm sure this is going to be reformed. There's no way that the people living in the cities are okay with fireworks going off right by their house constantly. So I'm sure this is going to be reformed one day to probably like only a smaller window of time instead of all day long. Whereas see, in the US we only have fireworks right at night and that's it. And in the US you can also, you can launch fireworks off at your house wherever, whenever, honestly, but that's at your own private property. You can't just go into a city and start launching fireworks. There's just no way. You would be arrested instantly. But in January there's also something called Grandmother's Day and Grandfather's Day. Grandmother's Day is January 21st, Grandfather's Day is January 22nd, and I guess you just, you know, hang out with your grandparents, you just celebrate their day because they're grandparents or whatever, you know, cake, all that stuff, hang out, right? I'm sure that's kind of the thing. I don't really know because I haven't been involved in Poland on a Grandparents' Day at all, but this differs from the US because the grandparents, we have a day called Grandparents' Day in the US, it's September 8th. And it's not celebrated at all, and in fact I didn't even know this till I looked it up 5 minutes ago. So yeah, it's something that we don't do in the States at all, is anything grandparents related type of holiday typically. But yeah, I'm pretty sure this is somewhat of a, you know, big thing in Poland, like name day and your own grandparents day. So moving on to February, this is an interesting one that I wanted to get involved with. this past February, but I didn't because I didn't even know about it until recently, honestly. But there's a thing in Poland called Fat Thursday, and basically it's kind of where you eat like Polish desserts and goodies like punchki, and there's a bunch of other like donuts and kind of like bread related, cake related type of desserts that Polish people eat on this day. And it's on a Thursday. It's before Lent, I think, for the Catholic Church. I guess it's kind of before like a fast. People are pigging out and eating a lot of food. So yeah, it's pretty interesting, and I wanted to be involved with it so badly and eat some delicious punchki, but I wasn't. So this upcoming February, I will definitely be involved. So the next one in February is Valentine's Day. This is something actually we share common with Poland. So I looked this up and did a little bit of research about Polish Valentine's Day. And as far as I know, it's pretty much an adoption from the West, like the US. And it basically adopted the values of Valentine's Day, which is basically just giving candies to your loved ones, or, you know, cards, envelopes, heart-shaped chocolates. You know, it's honestly the same thing as here. All right, so moving on to the next one. On March 8th, there's something called International Women's Day. And it's actually much bigger in Poland than it is here. I didn't even know about Women's Day until I started dating my Polish girlfriend. So I guess guys are giving flowers and chocolates and, you know, small gifts to their girlfriends, loved ones, you know, wives and their daughters.
All right, guys, I forgot to mention that Easter is another super important holiday in Poland. And I don't know how I forgot, but I'm just looking at my clip right now and I noticed that I forgot. So during Easter, it's pretty much the same as the US, but it's just a little bit different. So in Poland, people are giving baskets to the church with like bread, meats and eggs and some things like that, and some decorated eggs as well to the church, just to donate kind of, I guess, as a way of, you know, their blessings to the church. That's not really a thing in the US, and I don't think even Catholics here do that. But, you know, Easter is still a big day here, as it is in Poland, more so in Poland, I would say now. But so also with Easter is that students get off typically for like 1 to 2 weeks, and I'm pretty sure workers get off for definitely at least a few days. So that's another difference right there, is that there's more time off in Poland for this holiday for sure.
All right, so moving on to May, there is Mother's Day on May 26th in Poland. And in the US, it's actually May 12th. And it's pretty much the same thing. You're basically just celebrating your mom, you know, cards, flowers, gifts, some things like that. And moving on to Father's Day, which is June 23rd in Poland, and is actually June 16th in the US. It's pretty much the same thing as here in the States. It's just, you know, about giving cards to your father and gifts and just hanging out with them, appreciating them for all they've done. Now, moving on, there's something called Day of the Dead in Poland, which is November 1st. And it's not similar to Halloween, which is October 31st. All right, so on Day of the Dead in Poland, people are going to their ancestors' graves and basically like leaving lamps, candles, flowers near their graves to basically just like reminisce them and their times that they had here on the earth. And it's also kind of a celebration, as far as I know, for their lives. But it's also kind of a gloomy, sad day of kind of like sadness for those who passed. I know it's also called like All Saints Day or something like that, where churches are going out to the graves and basically like reminiscing people's time here. Now, this honestly completely differs from Halloween. We don't do anything like that here. It's kind of interesting, but, you know, here we're dressing up as like characters or monsters or really anything you can dress up as, honestly, now. And you're going door to door asking for candy as a kid. And then adults, there's typically parties where you're dressing up and, you know, drinking alcohol. And there's also haunted houses and things like that, where people are dressing up as kind of scary things in you're walking throughout the houses. It's kind of like a maze, and you're going through all these horrific things and themes like clowns, nurses, butchers, and stuff like that. So it's an interesting time here, and if you're Polish and you're in the US around October to November, I highly recommend to go to a haunted house and kind of experience that, because it's quite awesome. All right, so moving on to November 11th, which is Poland's Independence Day. So this is pretty similar to July 4th in the US, but it seems a lot more patriotic. From what I've seen, the video clips, the pictures, seems to be like there's a lot more patriots for Poland. This is where people are marching, holding Polish flags, and kind of celebrating Poland's independence. It's pretty crazy. It looks like a fun time, and I would be honored to join Poland on their Independence Day. And I'm pretty sure there's fireworks at the end of the day. I'm not exactly sure about this, but compared to the US, there's usually like, you know, some small parades or sometimes big parade, and you know, there's just fireworks at the end of the day, and it's usually like a barbecue cookout type of thing. For me, for July 4th, usually I'm always going over to like a family member's house and having a barbecue and some small fireworks and stuff like that. It's usually pretty small. But for the most part, usually there's just food, fireworks, and that's it. There's not really much of marching and, you know, all that.
Hey, what's up, guys? So I'm just editing this clip right now, and I forgot to mention Thanksgiving, which on the US is November 28th. And it's basically just a time of eating a lot of food, particularly turkey, stuffing, mashed potatoes, gravy, cranberries and stuff like that, with pumpkin pie, apple pie, all of that. But that's a really big important holiday that I forgot to mention. It is definitely an awesome time food wise. It's definitely one of the best in the States.
All right, so moving on to another interesting one that we don't really celebrate, which is Saint Nicholas Day. And this is December 6th. I guess it's like Santa's Day or something like that. As far as I know, in Poland, you know, Santa is giving gifts to children. So I'm pretty sure that this is a children's day, because I don't think that we celebrate this at all in the US. And I mean, personally, with my family, we never have. So as far as I know, it's pretty much just Santa Claus giving gifts towards children. So moving on to Christmas in Poland, which is actually the 24th, the 25th, and the 26th of December. So whereas in the US, it's really just Christmas Eve and then Christmas Day. Okay, so Christmas in Poland is mostly different towards the US. In Poland, it's about spending time with family, cooking, getting together with family, hanging out, talking, and basically just experiencing each other. And this is with just a small amount of gifts. Whereas in the US, it's, from what I can remember growing up, it's just about gifts. That's all it's kind of become in the US now, is just this materialism. It's pretty sad, because like whenever I went over to Poland for Christmas, I was so surprised that it was just about hanging out, not receiving gifts or giving gifts or whatever. It's just about being with family, hanging out, talking. And this was so enjoyable for me that I want to spend every Christmas in Poland for the rest of my life because of how awesome it was. It wasn't about giving gifts or anything like that. And I know this sounds weird to Polish people, but it was honestly shocking to me that it was just about hanging out with family and that's it. Because obviously in the US it's about hanging out with family and stuff, but you know, just growing up as a kid, it's just, there's so many gifts. So in Poland, it's three super important days of Christmas, and it seems like it's not just like in the US where it's Christmas Eve and then Christmas. In Poland, it's like Christmas Eve, Christmas, the 26th. And it's all of equal value and importance there as well. Alright guys, so that's pretty much it today. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't already, check out my other videos, and I've done a few more now about the differences between Poland versus USA. So yeah, that's pretty much it today. More videos soon, and I want to thank you so much for your support recently. It's just, it's meant a lot, and it's almost overwhelming at this point. It's crazy. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any recommendations, leave them down below. And until next time, dziękuję i do widzenia.